Hey, you don't want to hear the accent of a fucking Frenchie who doesn't know English trying to give you a tutorial. So, this video is going to put the AI of 2020 to the test with a DeepL translation and the voice synthesizer CP77 xVASynth.
Not easy to say.
Sorry for those who find it disturbing, but it's pretty fun to play with these tech. I'm especially worried that DeepL won't do a natural translation, anyway. This tutorial is made to allow anyone to create the shadow hair version of a modded haircut. Let's go. For this example, we will make the request of Nekuanate by recreating the bubblegum hairstyle of Noralee's mod. First of all, let's get the modding kit from the shadow hair page. The archive contains what you need, as well as links to the three programs we're going to use. I'll let you install them by yourself. I will only explain the installation of the Neusys plugin. The haircut is composed of models 52 and 98, one available in low poly and one high poly. We will mix these two haircuts with the simplified bodies used for the shade. To do this, open Blender. After removing the base cube, import our base, the female body. We use FBX files in Blender. You will find the female body in the FBX body folder of the modding kit. PMA is for men, and PWA is for women. You can move around using the wheel button and the shift key. And by the way, you can delete if you want the collection, the camera, and the light that will not be useful for us. And let's finish the import by getting both haircuts to mix. And that's it, the mesh we are going to edit are the orange triangles. On the high poly there are often several superfluous layers that we will remove. We can see that the part to be removed is the back of Claire's hair. To do this, select the corresponding mesh and press tab with your mouse on the 3D display area. Then the polygons become selectable and deletable. You can now select and delete them. The long part of the operation, but also the part where somewhere you create something new. Before merging the three submeshes, we need to make sure that they are all linked so that the hair does not come off the body when moving. Unfold then the tree of the submeshes and then the vortex groups. On the hair, the uppercase names must have shadow underscore in front of them to match the vortex groups on the body. We notice that the low poly are always correct. Now to merge the submeshes, first select the hair, then the body, and press Ctrl J to merge the hole on the body. Delete the empty groups that are now useless to us. Delete materials to leave no more than one or the conversion to the red engine and format will crash. And that's it, you can do an FBX export to get our file out of Blender and repeat the operation for the male body. Now Neusys. It's used to switch a 3D file from red engine format to FBX format and vice versa. But for that it needs a magic plugin designed by our community. Put the content of the archive in the Python folder of the plugins folder of Neusys. Then you can launch Neusys. Launch a .mesh export and a window will appear. Go and find the .mesh file corresponding to the gender of your file in the mesh body folder of the modding kit. And repeat with the other gender. And open the archive folder. This folder was prepared with the male mesh with Johnny's hair. So we will start with the Johnny version of the archive. And for that replace the two female files by yours. Then open CP77 Tools, now WolvenKit.CLI. Two commands to enter to create the archive, rebuild, space dash P space folder path, space dash B space double dash, keep, and pack, space dash P space folder path. And that's it, now I just have to do it again replacing also the male files to make the classic archive. And it's finished, all we have to do is put our file in the mod folder and test it in game.